Range 1 and set the speed to full. By clicking the right mouse button on the filled box tool, the fill requester is displayed. Set the dither to none and select the horizontal gradient. With grid turned on, make a rectangle that's 2 grid spaces high and 4 wide. Turn on Exclude Brush, then pick up the rectangle as a brush. Clear the screen, and using the custom brush, make a large checkerboard pattern. Next, pick up a piece of the pattern that is 6 squares high and 6 squares wide. Then clear the screen. By turning color cycle on, it appears as though the red and white squares are moving, but this is just an illusion caused by the shifting colors. From the fill requester, choose Wrap. Turn on B square so that the circle is proportionally shaped. When we make a circle, we see the pattern is being wrapped around the ball. Now color cycle again. The ball appears to spin, but as I said earlier, this is just an illusion. Pick up the ball as a brush and clear the screen. Use Prespective to tilt the ball. Once again, pick up the ball and clear the screen. Now for the animation. Set the frame count to 20. And stamp the ball near the bottom of the screen. Then bring up the move requester. Set the Y distance to 100, and to create a gravity effect, set Ease In to 20. Preview will show the move. Click Draw to create the 20 frames of the move. To see the ball bounce, select from the Anim Control menu Ping Pong or press 6. Use Shift 1 to get to frame 1. Once again, pick up the ball. This time, hold down the left Amiga or Commodore key so that DPaint grabs it as an Anim brush. Remember to pick up the entire area that the ball bounces within. Now that we have an Anim brush, clear all the frames. Hold the Anim brush by the lower corner. Next, in the Anim brush settings, select Ping Pong. This changes the Anim brush length to 38 for a complete loop. Next, we'll set the frame count to match. We'll go back to frame 1, and since the number of frames is 38, set the current brush frame to 19, which is in the middle. A right mouse button click on the line tool brings up the spacings requester. Set N total to 38, giving 38 steps in a line. F10 will turn the menu bar off. Now position the ball on the left with the pointer at the bottom of the screen. While holding down the left Amiga or Commodore key and the left mouse button, drag a line across the bottom edge of the screen. When you release the mouse button, DPaint steps through, stamping one anim brush frame on each animation page. Now turn color cycling on and press 6 to see the animation play back in a ping-pong fashion. Although these demonstrations may not match your applications exactly, they may provide you with helpful concepts. Try combining some of these techniques to fulfill your specific graphic needs. Deluxe Paint III is the kind of program that invites experimentation, so feel free to play around with its various tools and effects. You may even discover an artistic side you never knew you had.